I believe that electrification of transportation is one of the most important things that we're going to do in the 20s. By bringing in clean, renewable energy mixed out with transportation, it's one of the easiest goals, and one of the easiest boxes that we can check right now on how to reduce our greenhouse emissions.
The NREL Eaton partnership is unique because we actually have staff on site to work with our researchers. So they have co-located to the Energy Systems Integration Facility. We have about 20 employees on site. What they want to do is be able to leverage working with the researchers, our amazing capabilities, and having impact.
In this project, we're working with Eaton to develop a co-optimization framework for electrifying vehicle fleets. The platform itself currently looks at how do we optimally size the fleet, how do we electrify the fleet to make the most economical sense, what are the different grid services that the fleets can offer, how are the fleets being used to begin with, what are the opportunities for charging during the use of the fleet. We also want to be aware that when we have a large-scale electrification of a fleet, it leads to local grid issues as well. So we want to make sure that the utilities are also aware of what's going on when we have a fleet being electrified.
One of the things that we need to think about is how fast will this adoption occur, and how do we need to change our processes and procedures to accommodate that? What will these devices mean for our system, and how do we prepare for that?
Collaboration is one of the most important parts in this. I think it's very important for the bus manufacturers, the fleets, and the transit authorities to work with the utilities so they can understand what the costs are going to be and what the impacts of moving their fleet to 10%, 20%, or 100% over the next 30 years.
In this project, we have an industry advisory board where we have brought stakeholders from all across the industry. Our stakeholder advisors include original equipment manufacturers, fleet operators like UPS and Amazon and Walmart, utility companies from around the country, and also vendors like Eaton. Working with Eaton helps us because it's a touchstone to what's happening in the industry.
Eaton is a global company, 96,000 employees around the globe in every major continent. Over the last 15 months that we have been co-located here, we have been bringing people from every continent in here. And they just share how the problems look like in their neck of the wood. So bringing those kind of a people in the same room really creates incredible dynamics, and people much faster come up with what we are calling minimum viable products and other more entrepreneurial approaches that really enables innovation to be faster and to de-risk it from the very get-go.
We are looking for more partners, definitely, to help us take these case studies forward. We want to demonstrate the flexibility of the framework to include other case studies like transit electrification, long-haul fleet electrification, and so we're always looking for partners to collaborate on these future case studies.